Children, we continue with our chapter. Last week we began with a new chapter, a new topic, natural regions. Okay, so today we continue with the chapter. During our last period of geography, children, we studied about the regions, the different regions in the world. The entire land area on the earth's surface is divided into various natural regions. So we had to study tundra region, taiga region, grasslands, steppes and prairie region, hot desert region, grasslands, that is Sudan type, and equatorial region. Okay, last week we studied four different types of regions: tundra, taiga, grasslands and hot desert. This week, today we'll learn hot desert region. No, hot desert region we finished, children. Today we'll learn grasslands, those are Sudan type, an equatorial region. Besides these two, there are the others. Later on the slide, you get to know which other two we are going to study. Okay, so the first thing now is grasslands, Sudan region. Grasslands of the Sudan region, children. These grasslands are located between 5 degree to 20 degree north and south parallels. That means they are in both the hemispheres, the northern hemisphere as well as the southern hemisphere. Okay, now these are called out by different names. In this region, children, you can see the location, 5 degree to 20 degree. That means not very far away from the equator. So therefore, this region, the summers are hot and humid, and the winters are warm and dry. Summers are very hot because close to the equator, children, and the winters are warm and dry. Now these regions are named by different names in different continents. In Africa, these regions are called as savanna grasslands. These grasslands are names. They are called as Queensland. Africa, they are called as parkland. And children, in South America, they are called as llanos and campos. Okay, campos. Once again, savannas in Africa, Queensland in Australia, parkland in Africa, and llanos and campos in South America. Children, you need to know them because this could be asked for your match the columns. Now, tall and thick grasses are mainly found in this region. Because of the rainfall and sunlight, tall and thick grasses are mainly found in this region. Large number of herbivorous and carnivorous animals are seen in this region, children. Number of animals are quite large. Herbivorous as well as carnivorous animals you'll find in the grasslands. That is Sudan type of grasslands. This nature has gifted, now look at these animals on the slide, children. Variety of animals you get to see. Nature has gifted all of them with speedy legs. Skin of these animals has colorful spots or stripes or bands, children, so that they are protected because many people go on hunting and all, hunting these animals. Okay, their occupation at times is hunting. So to be safe in those grasslands, nature has gifted them with colorful spots, stripes, bands, etc. Now the animals that you can, the tall and thick grasses is mainly found in this region. Large number of herbivorous and carnivorous animals are seen in this region, and the names of the animals they have given: lion, cheetah, hyena. Now hyena is an animal, it's like a wild animal, like a dog. Okay, that eats the meat of other animals. So this is a hyena. Hyena is an animal like a dog. After that, wolf, zebra, giraffe, elephant, rhino, buffalo, kangaroo, and emu. Emu is a bird with long legs. Emu is a bird with long legs. It cannot fly. So these are the different animals that you get to see in the grassland regions of the Sudan or savanna. Now, what about the human life over here? Houses in this region are quite simple, children, with mud walls and thatched roofs. There are no windows at all for these houses. Very, very simple houses. They are short in height and they are dome-shaped. These are huts which are short and they are in a shape of a dome. Okay, they are called as kraals. These houses are called as kraals. Look at the shape of the house. No windows at all. Only one door where they could enter in. So these are called as kraals. Now hunting and rearing of animals is the main occupation here. So look at the tribes found over there. These are the tribal people of these grassland region of savanna, prairie region, Sudan region. Now these are called as Zulus. Some are called as Hausas. Then Maasai, some of them are called as Maasai. They are named by different names, children. The tribes include, there are many tribes, but some of the major tribes over here that you get to see in the grassland regions are Zulus, Hausa, and Maasai. Now we move ahead, children. We move to the equatorial region. Now equatorial region, children, is a region which is closer to the equator. Which is very, very close to the equator. This is your equator, 0 degrees Celsius. So equatorial region extends in between 5 degrees north and 5 degrees south. Between 5 degrees north and 5 degrees south parallels of the equator, you have the equatorial region. Now the regions which experience, the countries which experience equatorial region are Malaysia, Indonesia, Singapore, Guinea. This is called as Guinea, okay? Congo Basin, then Amazon Basin over here. Amazon Basin, Congo Basin, and the Asian parts, okay? Some parts of the Asia. So these experience equatorial region. Myanmar and the other countries are here. Okay? Dense evergreen, hot climate over here. The climate over here, you can imagine, closer to the equator. So the climate is hot and humid. And the heat is so bad that most of the times what happen, climate is hot and humid. Vegetal litter decomposes. That means the vegetation over there decomposes and that spreads many diseases. Okay, the vegetal litter decomposes due to strong heat and that is why it leads to many diseases. Dense evergreen forest. Look at the forest that you can see over here. Dense evergreen forest with variety of tall hardwood trees and bushes are seen in this region. The forests over here are very dense because they receive rainfall as well as a lot of sunlight. So the trees grow tall and small bushes also you get to see in this region. Variety of animals and birds are seen in this region. In the forest of this equatorial region, you get to see variety of birds as well as animals. Crocodiles, chimpanzees, hippopotamus, then these big anacondas, then gorillas and all. These are the different types of animal life that you get to see in the equatorial region. One more thing, children, I didn't tell you and there's no picture over here. There's a fly, poisonous insect that you get to see in this equatorial region. That insect is called as tsetse, T-S-E-T-S-E. Okay, it is spelled as T-S-E-T-S-E. It's just like a fly, but it's a poisonous insect. It's an African fly which bites humans and animals and sucks their blood. Okay, it is called as tsetse, T-S-E-T-S-E. It's a tsetse fly, which is poisonous. It's same like a fly, house fly, a little bigger than the house fly. Now, the human settlements in this region are few. Human settlement is sparse. Okay, human life is dependent on the nature. Population is mostly tribal. In these equatorial forest region, children, the population is mostly tribal. People build houses on the trees. Equatorial region, people build houses on the trees. Tribes over here are named like Pygmies, Pygmies of Africa, then Boro Indians, then Seamang and etc. So the major tribes in this equatorial region are Pygmies, Boro Indians and Seamang.